Can you imagine what's happening out at RIT? It's just, well, I've said it five times now, but it's fun.
You don't have to. Norma Holland is here to tell us about Imagine RIT.
Norma, here we go.
Norma. Hello, Norma. Oh, not quite ready.
Oh.
I hear you.
Oh, hey.
Oh, there you are. Now you're on TV.
You're on right now.
Hello.
Yes, hello, everyone.
Hi. Hello,
how are you?
Sorry about that.
No problem.
Okay, we have a real treat for you. Because as we said, here at the Imagine RIT Festival, there is all sorts of things going on. We've got musical performances. This is a day to really celebrate the creativity of the people who are students and staff here. And with us this morning, we have two very interesting guys here. What's your name?
I'm Brent.
Brent, and you are?
I'm Bryce.
Okay. Brent and Bryce Salmi belong to the K2...
GXT.
GXT Amateur Radio Club. And if you ever thought radio meant just what's on the dial, nah, we've got a real treat for you. You guys are in charge of a really cool exhibit. Tell me all about it.
Well, we're the Amateur Radio Club here at RIT, and our project for Imagine RIT this year is a high-altitude balloon.
Okay.
And this will be launched up to about 100,000 feet.
So three times the height of an airliner.
Yes.
Okay.
And we'll see the curvature of the Earth, the black of space. We'll be taking pictures. We'll be taking different temperatures, and we'll also be able to track it live as it's flying.
Yeah. So you at home, if you don't get to come out to the festival for whatever reason, and it is Saturday, it's free. It's starting at 10 o'clock in the morning. You can actually track this balloon. Now, this is not the actual balloon. This is just sort of. A replica, if you will, of what you will see. So people can actually track the temperature, the height, all sorts of really cool readings from that high in the atmosphere.
Yeah, and they can go to www.collegearc.com/ARHAB.
And we're going to have a link on our website. So if any of you science people out there who want to follow this, we'll have the link up on our website for you. So this is just really cool because you get to show people what you do every day here at school.
Yeah, and this is kind of our way of taking what we learn in class and applying it to do something really cool. And I think we've come together as a club and tried to show people what they haven't seen in amateur radio yet. You know, we're not just the people sitting down and talking across the world. We do that, but we also take it and meld it into these other areas, like going into near space.
Yeah, near space. When they told me they were gonna go or send this thing into near space, I was like, really? Near space? It sounds like something from a sci-fi movie, but it's very applicable to today, isn't it?
Hey, Norma.
It is. In near space.
Hold on. Yeah, Doug?
Oh, go ahead. I just remember one time when we sent you out live somewhere and we almost sent you into near space. You remember that?
Yeah, I remember that. They almost sent me into near space on this ride at Darien Lake. It was, again, you're the Amateur Radio Club, but it's not just ham radio. It's not just talking to people around the world, like your brother said.
Exactly. We're into that, but we're also into electronics. We're into the new technologies. We're programming. We're doing electronics. We're experimenting. And we're using amateur radio in very unique ways.
Yeah.
So we're having a lot of fun.
Yeah. This thing is going to be launched on Saturday, right?
Yes.
The balloon. This is just the replica because the actual balloon is how big?
The actual balloon is about 6 to 8 feet wide when we fill it up. And we'll be launching on Saturday from here at RIT. Depending if the FAA lets us, we'll find out today. So we'll let people know. We're going to let people know.
It's FAA dependent.
You know
you're pretty...
But it will be launched.
You know you're pretty important when the FAA's got to give you a thumbs up or thumbs down. Hey, by the way, did you notice these guys are twins? I don't know if you can tell.
Twins from Canada, I'm guessing.
Yeah, are you guys from Canada?
No, we're not. We're actually from the Boston area.
From Boston?
The Boston area.
All right.
We've lost our accents.
Wrong.
Okay. All right, Imagine RIT. We're going to have more for you coming up. DNA necklaces.
All right, thanks, Norma.
We're also
good job, guys.
Study a map.
I thought they sounded they had a Canadian accent. Did anybody else hear that?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Exactly. They said a boot, and they did look like twins. Are you?